afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I am the researcher in the Institute of Polymers, Bulgarian Academy of Sciences, and I have a pleasure of presenting you current research and development in the field of biodegradable material polymers in the Institute of Polymers, Bulgarian Academy of Sciences. This is the building of the Institute of Polymers, and Institute of Polymers is the country's leading center of research and innovations in the field of polymer science. Institute of Polymers is the autonomous research unit that belongs to the Nanoscience, New Materials and Technology Division of the Bulgarian Academy of Sciences. Institute of Polymers consists of 6 independent laboratories, and they have clearly defined thematic scopes with the research objectives, which are in compliance with the research priority of the Institute. The staff of the Institute is polymer, numbers 60 employees, 49 of them being researchers. 12 PhD students at the present are trained at the Institute of Polymers. The young research staff has been considered one of the most important advantages of the Institute of Polymers. Institute of Polymers accomplishes its mission. This is to do advanced research and education on polymer and polymer materials and to transform the generated knowledge into innovative materials, products, technologies in response to the needs of industry and society. Research activities and expertise of the Institute of Polymers are concerns with the synthesis, modification, characterization of polymers, and development of new polymer materials with tailored properties directed towards the biomedical applications, environmental protections, materials for agriculture and food preservation, and also materials for alternative energy production. A considerable part of the researches in this institute includes investigations on biodegradable polymer materials design and application. For the preparation of new materials in the Institute of Polymers, bio-based and biodegradable polymers such as polysaccharides, polylactic acid and copolymers, polyhydroxyl conoids and its copolymers are used. These polymers nowadays have attract considerable interest because of their biodegradability, biocompatibility, and lack of toxicity. Moreover, this polymer have considerable attractive features because they are produced from renewable resources. They are product of plant origin, product of marine origin, or byproduct of bacterial fermentation processes. Novel materials prepared from these polymers might be used in biomedicine, in agriculture, for food preservation, and so on. Laboratory of Bioactive Polymers in the Institute of Polymers has a great expertise in properties, modification and processing of the above mentioned polymers. Bio-based and biodegradable polymers have been used in this laboratory for the preparation of novel materials such as hydrogels, beads, nanoparticles, and electrospun, micro and nanofibers. For the first time, the polyelectrolyte complexes between N-carboxyethylhydrozan, this is derivative of hydrozan, and non-quaternized and quaternized polydimethylamino ethyl methacrylate have been prepared, and the modification of hydrozan in N-carboxyethylhydrozan gives a possibilities of preparation of polyelectrolyte complexes at the pH range in which the hydrazone cannot form the complexes. For example, carboxyethyl hydrazone and non-quaternized polydimethyl aminoethyl metacrylate are formed in the narrow pH range, which is around 7. Quaternization of the tertiary amino groups of PDMA-EMA gives a possibility of formation of polyelectrolyte complexes in neutral and in alkaline conditions. The investigation of the behavior of these polyelectrolyte complexes in contact with blood revealed that these complexes lost the inherent cytotoxicity of PDMA-EMA, but still preserved the hemotoxic, hemostatic properties. And these results clearly show that the materials based on polyelectrolyte complexes, on the obtained polyelectrolyte complexes, may be used as undressing materials. For the first time, stealth nanoparticles based on biodegradable polymer and carboxyethyl hydrazone have been prepared, and this was triggered by formation of polyelectrolyte complexes between N-carboxyethyl hydrazone and double hydrophilic block copolymers. Based on the appropriate choice of partners or of medium conditions, the spherical stealth nanoparticles with polyethylene oxide shelf has been prepared, and they are stable both in alkaline and in acidic medium. The prepared stealth nanoparticles can be a potential candidate for a variety of biomedical applications. Nanocomposites, which are biodegradable from polyhydroxybutyrate and from organomodified clay, montmorillonite, have been prepared. And from the obtained HIX-RD results, at filler loadings higher than 3 weight percent, intercalation of the clay with polymer matrix is observed. At lower clay concentration, exfoliation dominates. In laboratory of bioactive polymers, a lab-scale technology for the preparation of nanofibrous materials from biocompatible and biodegradable polymers with tailored biological properties on contact with cells have been developed. And here are the examples for the use of aliphatic polyesters and hydrazone by applying the modern technique electrospinning are shown. By combining the properties, the useful properties of hydrazone and aliphatic polyesters with unique properties of the electrospun materials, it is a very powerful strategy for preparation of new materials that can be found a lot of applications in biomedicine. Here are the examples for such nanofibrous materials which may find applications as wound healing devices with antibacterial and hemostatic properties, as tissue engineering scaffold that promote the growth and the adhesion and the proliferation of some osteoblasts and fibroblasts, and also the fullerene-containing nanofibrous materials that may find application for cancer therapy. Electrospinning also is possible to use it for preparation of novel drug-loaded fibrous materials, polylactic acid-based bundles loaded with very efficient drugs with local anesthetic, anti-inflammatory and antibacterial properties have been fabricated. The self-organization of the fibers in into bundles was initiated by the designed in the laboratory multi-needle electrodes. The prepared materials may find applications in wound dressing, as wound dressing materials or as materials in regenerative medicine. And also the obtained results from these experiments might easily be transferred in pilot or in industrial scale. The combination of the outstandingly promising method of electrospinning with the possibility of formation of polyelectrolyte complexes is a very effective tool for preparation, for modulating the surface properties of the fibrous materials. And the in vivo test showed here that the preparation of the polyelectrolyte complexes between carboxyethyl hydrazone and D-block copolymer on the surfaces of fibrous materials from biodegradable polymers impart hemostatic properties to these biodegradable fibrous materials. These results clearly show that the polyelectrolyte complexes coated fibrous materials may find applications as wound dressing materials. In the laboratory of bioactive polymers, a lab-scale technology for preparation of biodegradable polymer systems having biological activity, which are suitable for wound healing applications, have been developed, and these materials is easy to electrospun directly onto the injured place. I show also one application for preparation of fibrous materials that containing anti-tumor drug doxorubicin, and these electrospun materials are prepared from biodegradable polymers, quaternized hydrazone and copolymer of L-lactate and DL-lactate. The in vivo performed test showed that these nanofibrous materials containing anti-tumor drug are highly effective against HeLa tumor cells, and a local insertion of these nanofibrous implants containing doxorubicin into the place of the removed tumor led to an increase of the animal survival rate and also to a decrease of the percentage of recurrences and metastasis. These results clearly show that the nanofibrous implants containing doxorubicin are very useful as anti-tumor drug delivery systems in post-operative applications in treatment of the solid tumors. Regarding the agriculture applications, lab-scale technology for embedding of biocontrol agents, microorganism Trichoderma viride, has been developed and thus creating environmentally friendly plant protection systems based on fibrous membrane, which is from biodegradable polymer chitosan. Furthermore, it has been demonstrated that the embedded in the nanofibrous materials microorganism Trichoderma viride impede the growth of the plant pathogen fusarium and thus ensure very favorable conditions for plant growth. A rich in nature hydrogen phosphonated group is used for the preparation of polyphosphoesters, which having different functionality and phosphorus center, and this biodegradable polymer can be designed to have non-toxic building blocks such as polyethylene oxide blocks and can find applications in drug delivery. a visible method for converting some used polymers like polyurethanes, polycarbonates, and polyamides or polymer waste into reusable phosphor-containing oligomers have been developed, and the esters of hydrogen phosphonic and phosphoric acids was used for the chemical degradations of polyurethanes, polycarbonates, and polyamides. The degradation products can be used successfully for the preparation of new materials with reduced flammability. And here are the scientific equipments in Institute of Polymers that was used for the characterization of polymer and polymer materials. Part of this scientific equipment was bought during the last 5 years thanks to the financial support from the National Science Fund in Bulgaria and thanks to some incomes from the analytical services. Here are the current projects of the Institute of Polymers, which are funded by framework projects of European commissions, by structural funds, and by the National Science Funds in Bulgaria. Institute of Bulgaria has also very fruitful bilateral cooperations with some academic institutions from the different countries of the Europe and rest of the world. Institute of Polymer have very fruitful also collaborations with other research groups in Bulgaria and a part of the investigations of the presented on this slide research groups in Bulgaria includes the investigations and development of the bio-based or biodegradable polymer materials, which can find applications in biomedicine, pharmacy, for environmental protections, and in biotechnology. Institute of Polymers keeps also contacts with polymer material related companies in Bulgaria through their branch organization, Bulgarian Association Polymers. This association represents 37 Bulgarian companies processing and marketing polymers and plastics. Also, it is actively affiliated of the Bulgarian Institute for Standardization and a member of the European Plastics Converts Association. Bulgarian Association Polymers actively monitors the alterations in the Bulgarian and European legislation concerning the plastics industry and business preserving interests. I want to pay your attention on the company Extrapak Ltd. Which at the present she has over 400 employees with annual turnover of more than 18 million of euro. Here are the main products which company produced, and these products consist of the non-biodegradable polymer bags, the main production, and biodegradable polymer bags, packages for industry, some plastics and paper, cups, boxes, bottles, and other standard products. Extrapak Ltd. is also the first company in Bulgaria with 100% automatic production of paper bags, and the only manufacturer of bags Ecoflex, which was produced from 100 compostable and biodegradable polymer. Extrapak Ltd. produces also different plastic bags and packages made from degrelen, which is oxo-degradable polymer. And for recycling purposes, Extrapak Ltd. has built a plant with total capacity of over 500 kilograms per hour. In conclusion, I think, in my point of view, that we researchers from the Institute of Polymer may contribute to the Plastis project with their knowledge on bio-based and biodegradable nano-sized and nano-structured materials. I would like also to thank to the organizers of this conference for giving me the possibility to present my lecture, and thank you for your attention.